Historically, great cities are often founded by great leaders. Alexandria by Alexander the Great, Baghdad by Al-Mansur, or St Petersburg by Peter the Great. But in the 21st century, it may be corporations rather than individual leaders who found the cities of the future. Leading the charge is Japanese auto giant Toyota. For the past several years, the company has been laying out designs for an entire small city near the base of Mount Fuji in Japan. The immediate purpose of this hyper-futuristic metropolis will be to test mobility systems, but it goes far beyond just that. Toyota says it will also be a living laboratory with roads and housing for 2,000 local residents. It will be named Woven City. In this episode of Looking For, we'll step onto the front lines of this extraordinary ongoing project. The location chosen for Woven City is the former site of Toyota's Higashi Fuji plant. The disused plant sits on the island of Honshu near the base of Mount Fuji in a small city called Susono. The plant officially closed in December 2020 after Toyota slashed production during the pandemic. The ambitious plan to build a city was first dreamed up by Toyota's mobility technology subsidiary, Woven. Woven was originally established in 2018 under the name TRIAD. The branch was created to develop software used in Toyota vehicles for safety and for automated driving. However, within just a couple of years, the group became almost entirely focused on a singular mission: to build a city of the future. The impetus for this seems to have been that Woven's team of expert scientists and engineers felt a testing ground was needed. In order to develop the mobility software of the future, developers would have to be able to experiment in real-world conditions. With the help of Woven Capital, an $800 million investment fund, the team quickly got to work. In April 2021, Woven purchased Level 5, the self-driving vehicle division, at Lyft. The total cost of the acquisition was $550 million. According to Woven CEO James Kuffner, the acquisition formed a dream team of world-class engineers and scientists. A dream team is exactly what Woven would need. They were embarking on a venture unlike any that Toyota had ever embarked on before. But before they could start building the city of the future, they would first have to design it. Perhaps the earliest decision to make when building a new city from scratch is to draw up what its borders will be. For Woven City, the team mapped out a 708,000 square meter area at the site of the former Susono plant. This is larger than Vatican City, but smaller than SeaWorld in San Diego. In other words, hardly diminutive, but not exactly sprawling either. The plan is for the city to eventually be home to 2,000 residents. However, according to Woven, there will only be 360 residents when the city is first opened. They chose a scenic area. Mount Fuji is only about 20 kilometers away, meaning the snow-capped peak is prominent on the horizon. It is also a relatively quiet, rural region when compared to other well-known areas in Japan. It's a nice spot for a city of the future to be, but what will the city of the future actually look like? According to lead architect Bjarke Ingels and the Woven team, the city will first and foremost consist of multiple layers, both above and below ground. Pedestrians, public transportation, urban logistics, commercial deliveries will all be divided into four separate roadway systems. The movement of goods will primarily take place underground. Pedestrians, cyclists, and self-driving vehicles will then each have their own separate paths above ground. Buildings will mostly be made out of wood, and roofs will feature photovoltaic panels. Although Woven has provided some eye-catching footage of 3D models, when it comes to mapping out how the city will look, concrete details are hard to come by. That's because, according to Woven, the infrastructure and design are still under review. What seems clear is that the community will be closely connected, with residents living in apartment-style buildings. Woven also seems to be placing a major focus on pedestrians, which means that walking paths and green outdoor spaces are likely to be prevalent. As you may have guessed already, many of Woven City's residents will be Woven employees actively working on the project. Woven, nevertheless, sees these residents as crucial players in the success of the project just by virtue of their living in the city and providing real-time feedback. This begs the question, what might their lives be like? The ultimate vision behind Woven City is to offer a unique way of life to residents. Designers describe this way of life in 12 distinct categories. One of the key categories is energy. Woven City will be a carbon-neutral society, relying on hydrogen produced by the Japanese petroleum company Eneos. The city will even feature hydrogen gas stations where fuel cell electric vehicles can stop to refuel. All vehicles beyond those used for personal mobility will be self-driving. Given Woven's acquisition of Lyft's self-driving division, the promise of an entire city full of only self-driving cars is enticing. However, despite the fact it would technically be the first fully self-driving city in human history if completed on schedule, it's hard to see why residents would use cars all that much. After all, the distance from one end of the city to the other will probably only be about a kilometer at most. That said, the city will be an unprecedented testing ground for fully integrated automated transport, which could have a significant impact on much larger future cities. Another key category is agriculture. Woven City will not merely produce its own food. Through a partnership with the Japanese food corporation Nissin, Woven City will provide complete personalized meals to each individual resident. These will be based on collected data and created through the use of molecular nutrition science. Residents of Woven City will also have AI fully enmeshed into their daily lives. Everything from communications to waste management to home environment will be assisted or facilitated by AI technology. This is the essence of the Woven City project, to pioneer an urban environment where technology isn't merely a set of tools, but is in fact the fabric of the entire society. Residents will be constantly interacting with smart tech, much of which will be personalized and tailored to suit their individual wants and needs. This might seem like an exciting or maybe even slightly unnerving leap toward a possible future. But in the eyes of Toyota, this is simply the next step in a natural progression the company has been following for the last century. The company was founded in 1937 to build what was then a very futuristic technology, the automobile. After surviving World War II and emerging onto the global market in the 1960s, Toyota was on the front lines of a shift toward making cars that the average person could afford to buy. In fact, today, the Toyota Corolla is the greatest selling car ever made. Toyota continued to push the envelope when it launched the Prius in 1997. This was the first successful hybrid vehicle ever mass-produced. Not only did this catapult Toyota into the stratosphere, making it the largest automaker in the world, but it also marked a turning point in Toyota's history. Now, it wasn't just making cars, it was envisioning the future on a global scale. Toyota seems to have concluded that simply developing advanced, environmentally friendly vehicles may not be ambitious enough in this day and age. The smart vehicles of the future will have to be integrated into the larger fabric of the cities in which they drive. This, remarkably, means that Toyota wants to start designing and building those cities. In the company's own words, this marks the transition to become a true mobility company. All of this sounds like an inspiring vision, but what about the reality? Woven held its groundbreaking ceremony on Mount Fuji Day, February 23, 2021. Following a safety prayer ceremony, Phase 1 construction began on October 10, 2022. Phase 1 is expected to be completed by summer 2024. Surprisingly, little has been released about how the project is actually going. Woven has posted periodic update videos on its YouTube channel showing time-lapse footage of bulldozers digging holes and cranes maneuvering equipment. Clearly, construction is indeed underway, but as for the cost of the project and any noteworthy milestones so far, Woven has been relatively quiet. If this sounds concerning, well, there is more reason to be concerned. In September of 2023, Toyota announced it would be bringing Woven in-house and shaking up its executive structure. Most notably, James Kufner left as CEO and on October 1st was replaced by Hajime Kumabe. Several news outlets at the time reported this as though it signaled the end of Woven City. But although Toyota does reportedly intend to shift Woven's focus more toward production, it hasn't stated that the Woven City project is on hold. It does create some uncertainty about the future of the project, however. One can only hope to see such a visionary undertaking come to life, but after all, it is an extremely ambitious venture. These types of high-budget futuristic projects can be unpredictable. There is no way to know for certain what the finished Woven City will look like, or for that matter, when the finished product will arrive. One thing we can say for sure about the ongoing Woven City project is that it signals a seismic shift in what future projects in general might start to look like. As it turns out, Toyota is not the only company looking to build the city of the future, and it certainly will not be the last. Tolosa in the American Southwest, Neom in Saudi Arabia, and Chengdu Future City in China are just some examples of other ongoing projects around the world, all of which share Woven's aim of designing and building a futuristic smart city. Whether Woven will be the first to open one of these cities to the outside world is something no one can currently say for sure. But with its innovative designs and inspirational vision, it's safe to say the impacts of the project are already being felt. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please be sure to subscribe for more content like this in the future. That's all for now. I'll see you next time on Looking 4.